switch to Shopify, here's how to do it in a few easy steps. Sign up for a free trial at shopify.com and download.
On her Instagram.
What it do, my people? Welcome to Your Average at Best, the unbiased content. Yeah, the unbiased network. You know what I'm saying? The unbiased truth network. There it is. The unbiased truth network. Your average at best. Oh, man. We got a platypus ocean bug. A platypus ocean seal. Sound check. Sound check. Oh, great. What it do, my people? Royalty and family defending a drug addict, Damon Arnett. Yes, 93 people in the building. Let's go. Defending a drug addict from the gate. Yeah, crazy. It's given unbelievable. CJ never got this much, you know what I'm saying, admiration. Yes, CJ never got this much admiration. This is sad. This is by far the dustiest family on YouTube because there's no men in this house. By far the dustiest YouTube family right here. You got a 60-year-old mother liking everything that her daughter's boyfriend is doing. I mean, it's just sad. It's pathetic. It's absolutely pathetic. Yeah, it's absolutely pathetic. Let me check that sound one more time. Yeah, it's absolutely pathetic. Yeah, we good. Yeah, just pathetic. Unreal, bro. So let's jump right into this crazy situation, and then I'll acknowledge everybody in the building, man. Appreciate it. Mona De Janeiro, Michelle Hyatt, appreciate it, Tish. Squad Champ, what's going on? Hair Care Journey. Hey, thanks, Hair Care Journey, earlier for the, you know what I'm saying, the like and the comment you left. We appreciate that. Thank you. 217 in the building. Hit the like button, man. This is 4 days in a row. T66, appreciate it for the alley-oop. 4 days in a row. We hit the ground running. I told y'all, we not going to play no games. Yeah, we back committed. We back here. You know what I'm saying? That the Unbiased Truth Network, Your Average at Best, the Unbiased Truth Network. Matter of fact, I'm going to be making a channel called the Unbiased Truth Network. Yeah, so be on the lookout. I'm going to turn my, I'm just Jason Reacts. Yeah, I'm going to turn that into the Unbiased Truth Network. So, yeah, and over there, it's self-explanatory. The Unbiased Truth Network. New channel coming, y'all. New channel coming. The Unbiased Truth Network. And I already got it typed in. So if anybody try to hurry up and run and go get it, it's too late. I already, ka-ka. The Unbiased Truth Network will be up tomorrow. Facts. And I don't even like saying that facts shit. But yes, man, let's jump right into it. Shout out to Destiny React. You know what I'm saying? Let's go.
Hey, y'all. It's Destiny. And welcome back or Welcome to Destiny React. And I think you probably know Charlene and CJ had to go to court today. Now, they have been going to court for so long now. It just makes me wonder when will this be over. And now, the Dusty family, they said, was yelling out in front of the courthouse.
Yeah, they said tacky, terrible Tanya with them desert runners. Her and her daughter was yelling out in front of the courthouse. Yeah, just as dusty as can be, just ratchet. You know, man, just dusty. Just need to get they ones together, man. This is a crusty family. Let's go ahead and set this mood. Yeah, this is a, let's set the mood, man. This is a crusty, dusty family that just 323 in the building. Let's get it, man. This is a dusty, crusty family that just can't get it together, y'all. I mean, just real dusty, real tough. Just pathetic. Like a mother that should be telling her daughter the right thing to do is advocating for dudes like Damon Arnett, a whole Method Man. That's crazy that you got a 60-year-old mom that said CJ was the problem. And now you're out here advocating for a Dusty like Rico. This is sad, yo. That's crazy that they said it. Real guys, no matter what. Everybody got character flaws and little things, but that's crazy that CJ So Cool showed them something that they will never, I stamp it, they will never see that life again. And he was a piece of shit. But Rico is just, we're going to like his music. The whole family's going to love his music. Oh, man, it's going to be great. We're going to all be involved. We're going to get the daughters doing TikToks to his music. Oh, man, 408 in the building. Let's go, man. Yeah, just a Dusty family. And what did she say a couple days ago, y'all? This is how dirty she is. That's why royalty can't be trusted. Something's wrong with her. This is exactly why she's in love with Rico, because the woman herself is a Dusty, fam. What did she say just a couple days ago? I'm talking about just dirty. This woman needs actual help. Real talk. Now we see why her mom's with her all the time, because she's not smart enough to do things on her own. We didn't know that her mom's actually her caregiver. Yeah, she's her home care aide. Yep, we didn't know that. Because Charlene has to be a little behind. I'm talking about, we're going to the 20th floor. Her stop at the 13th. Yeah, we going all the way up to the 20th. Her stop at floor 13, 14, somewhere in there. It just don't quite all the way up. Hey, Charlene, come on. We going to floor 20. Mines don't go there. It don't go there. You know what I'm saying? But instead, what is she in love with? And I know y'all can't fall, living with him. Unbelievable that they will advocate for the Bobby jaw. Wow. They advocate. What up, PJ, man? I see you over there slapping them in the head with that content. Shout out to you, bro. Keep it going, man. We love that shit, my nigga. Let's go. Real shit, man. Everyday PJ in the bill. And I know you're getting more living with him. And I know you miss my love and my love and the club. Advocating for him. Look at this. That she said. Listen to this bum, y'all.
No, I could have just did a lot of belligerent things that I have done in the past, but you know, that really never gets you.
Look at this bum. What did she say? What was that with it? She was saying that she, all right, she ain't. Yeah. Look at this bum just lying.
Their video, as you guys know the difference. Insinuate, guys, is just
look.
Know the difference between good things, bad things, good
spirits,
evil spirits,
negative thoughts. Oh my God. This is crazy, yo. Whoever advocates for this girl, shout out to you for the $6 Cash App. We greatly appreciate all the support, even if it's a dollar. We appreciate it. Not going to trip. Thank y'all very much, man. This girl is sad, G. Something is stone cold wrong with this lady. Oh, my God, bro. Like, yo, what is wrong with her? We now clearly know something is definitely wrong with her. Something's wrong with her. We already know that. We already done an extensive, you know what I'm saying, you know, extensive brain, you know what I'm saying, studying of this thing that we found. It's like an archaeological fan, like a royalty, you know what I'm saying? A hut baby that'll come. I told y'all, the day I play hut baby, she came back the next day capping all on the line. She changes her. Hut baby at his finest. Go from crying when the camera's on, and then her daughter, the camera's off? The camera's off, Jalele? It's off? Okay. We got them, y'all. They gonna send us toys. Yep, we got them. They stupid. All I gotta do is say, the Royalty Nation, the biggest nation. That's all I gotta say. Royalty Nation, the biggest nation. Goofy as hell, boy. You ain't bad them three children, nothing in the last year. I mean, they are so dusty. Here, bro, they need baby oil. I promise her three oldest is like black and white. Yeah, back when we had the pliers on the TV, put the hanger on it to try to get 53 in, because you like, damn, man. Or you wanted to see the box. You remember when you had to type in the three numbers to see the videos and it wouldn't come in clear, but if you got it decent, you could see them for free and you just had to wait until videos just came on? Yeah, whole dusty situation, man. Just a dusty. Like, Something's wrong with this girl, bro. I swear, her brain, it just complete, her roller coaster just quite don't. Her roller coaster just stopped right there. Yeah, her roller coaster stopped right there, family. It just don't quite go all the way to the top. I swear her brain, it just complete, her roller coaster just quite don't. Thank you. I appreciate the dollar. Thank you very much for the dollar cash out. Greatly appreciate it, y'all. Appreciate it. Yeah, this is 4 days in a row. This is work. 4 days in a row. I'm cooking, multitasking. I'm doing pre-uploads. She's editing. We're doing pre-uploads and labs. I mean, come on. Look out for her, brother, dog. 4 days in a row. This ain't for fun. You know what I'm saying? Oh, it is fun, but yeah, this is real business right here. You know what I'm saying? We about to take a mud turkey's head off, a sand sloth, a creek beaver, a porch parrot, an air frog. Yeah, a sand dolphin. You know what I mean? A ravine roach. Yeah, a lake lizard, a lot lizard. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we can keep them going. A mud camel. Yeah. What you mean? A dust squirrel. You know what I'm saying? A family of dust squirrels. Yeah, real shit. Shout out to PJ. Her roller coaster stopped before the drop. Real shit, PJ said. Nigga like, yo, what the hell? Roller coaster stopped completely before the hill. Real top. I appreciate that. Super dope, Jason. Thanks for the laugh. Thank you. I appreciate that. Greatly appreciate that. Y'all, like, her roller coaster don't stop all. Her roller coaster stop as it's going. Because we got the Steel Phantom. The Phantom's Revenge. That hill is deep as hell. That first hill, boy, her joint stopped, nigga. Her shit won't connect. It stopped right there. Nigga, she do the mannequin challenge every day, just. Spot right here. Nigga, she do the mannequin challenge every day. Just yeah, just a whole mud dolphin, a mud turtle, an air falcon. Yeah, real top. Just all of the above. A sewer squirrel. Stay on her neck. I might go live tomorrow. Oh, that's what's up. Yeah, hey, yo, PJ might go live tomorrow. We come load that thing up and go crazy. Real shit. Please, like, yeah, a whole goddamn sewer snake. A goddamn river dolphin. Just, you all type of wood and beer cans is getting stuck in her blowhole. You know what I mean? Because she's a river dolphin, and dolphins don't belong in rivers. So that's what you get. Oh yeah, hell yeah. Let me see. Post the con. Cancel. You see how you can do that? Oh yeah, go to comments. Post a comment. I believe that's it right there. A whole air falcon. If this air falcon don't get out of here. Real talk, man. Something wrong with this girl, man. Just goofy. Hey, thanks somebody for the cash app. I appreciate it. It happened so fast, I didn't get a chance to see it. Damn, but I'm going to definitely go check them out and read it. 564 in the building, man. Hit the like button, subscribe. We appreciate it. Yeah, that link is up too. Stop playing. That link is up. Just weird, man. You see what I'm saying? Just lying.
Negative energy, positive energy. You know the difference between those type of things when it comes to, you know, just everyday life, everyday experience.
I don't know. Yeah, like What up with you, BJ?
What it do, big dog? You
hey, hear what me? It do, big dog?
Hey, man. I've been waiting on this all week.
Oh, my God, bro. How did this circle back around the block? Like, I thought this Damon Arnett was over.
Hey, man. He messed up. He messed up. Like, it's like Mike Tyson talking with the tease. He messed up.
And you see how they tried to keep it on the low, too? Like, see, what's crazy is, no, everyone continued to attack CJ about little daily life shit, but everybody that advocates for her will not even, like, yo, he's catching guns and drug charges. Like, y'all just gonna skip that? Y'all just gonna skip that?
Yeah.
y'all just gonna skip that? The nigga gotta go to a violation in Vegas, and he got new charges in Dallas.
Bro is, man, He really, man, just, nigga, you couldn't put it in your ass. I mean,
that's
just
what I said, a half
spit on it, and
I would have stuck that shit in my ass and been high as hell, like, ooh, ooh, a bop, 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 bamboo, tootie, fruity, little booty, nigga, fuck that.
I ain't going to jail. What you mean?
I'm not going to jail for a half a gram. I'm sticking that shit in my ass. Woo! Like, why would you do that?
Shoot, I'll be
get on white and red hats. That's what's up, nigga.
I'll be in jail all weekend just waiting. Just to get
real shit.
With no extra charges.
Nigga, I done stuck a half a gram of Method Man in my booty, motherfucker.
Shit. Hey, man, what is he talking about? Like, bro, you ain't from the hood, man. You would have went in.
How you keep getting caught with these millimeters of a gram, my nigga? Swallow it. Hurry up and snort it, nigga. I will look at a cop and say, nigga, what you gonna do? I just snorted it in front of you. You can't take it out my nose. It's gone. Oh, you gonna swipe my nose? No, nigga, I just snorted it in front of you. It's over.
Oh, God, man. We used to get pulled over by the cops. We'd be in there doing the most. And I had Miratin on my car back in the day, and they just be in the trying to get and see, and it's just the light is flashing right back on the ass. We end up drinking 40s and trying to swallow weed. Man, that fool's a goofball, man.
Ain't that fool? And then she just like, it's like she's even more in love with him. The more he keep going down, she's like get more admiration for the nigga.
Hey, stupid girls love thug niggas, man.
Right?
Smart girls love thug niggas, too, but, like, stupid girls really be falling for him. Like,
yep. Stupid girls really fall for him. I couldn't believe it when I was sitting down. I'm literally cutting a client the other day. I'm just looking through my phone, cutting him, just scrolling through, and I see right there, like, Damon Arnett arrested on. I'm like, nah, that must be some old shit. And I'm like, well, why would it be at the top of Google? It was at the top of Google. I'm like, oh, this is new. Nigga, I went into straight YouTube mode. Hurried up and rushed my nigga's haircut and said, oh, I got to get on, jump on this.
Oh, God, I seen your video first. I was like, oh, that's crazy.
Yep.
Then somebody shared it to me. I was like, damn, that's crazy.
Hell, like, yeah.
Let's take it over.
And then look, what I wanted to say about look right here. Tacky Tanya is also advocating for the bum. Yo, he got the whole family. Rico must have been dropping dick in all of the generations. Real shit.
Damn. All three?
Real shit. All three. Because you know in Vegas, 16, age of consent, you're legal with consent. So don't come over here with that bullshit.
God damn. Hey,
Where's she at? Tacky Tanya, man. Yeah, just advocate. Beefing with niggas online. Like, you beefing with your daughter's baby dad online. Y'all are dirty.
She's still in the club with her daughter with her goof ass with her dirty feet.
Yeah, right? Like, when this shit end, man? Y'all a trash family. Y'all really need men in y'all life.
She can't even wear heels no more. Her old ass can't even wear heels no more. Them ankles is toe.
Right? look, what did she say? Lying your ass off in court. Oh, my God. I'm so broke. All my meals are free in any restaurant I walk in. I have no money. Like you said, it's better driving off in a Lambo. So tell yourself without telling on yourself 2 hours of lies. Like, what are you talking about, man?
Yo, damn. So So basically, she's putting her nose where it don't belong.
Yep.
First of all, like, his money don't belong to you or your daughter, because when it did belong to her, she didn't take advantage of it and make her own bag.
Nope.
The goofball sat around, got high for 9 years.
For 9 years.
At the beginning, she was down.
Yep.
You see all the videos from the beginning?
Yep. She was like, involved. She was down. That ego or something happened.
Mm-hmm. And she just fell off. She just fell back and let CJ run the show. And then that's when the kids kind of fell off. And you see how it is right now. They not no influencers, man. If you sitting over here doing.
How do you go from a major? I always want to ask, like, how do you go from being, you see all the other females that came from a YouTuber dude or was a family. They're thriving still. They, like, all of them. Mm-hmm. Charlene, you got 2.4 on Instagram, 1.4 inherited on YouTube. How are you under us? How is me and PJ and people like that? You've been on here for 10 years. How are we over you?
Yeah. What bum activity.
Up? How did this nigga PJ get, how did PJ mass damn near 20,000 new goddamn subscribers and this girl from 16,000 and she got 1.4 with a whole push and she can't even get 5,000 new subscribers?
Because don't nobody want to watch. They falling asleep. They try to hit the like button.
Yep.
Oh, shit.
We told her, man, the best place she could have done when she left CJ, she should have went into full damsel in distress. I mean, everybody would have gave to her. Everybody would have had heartstrings for her. But she went into thug royalty, and that didn't work.
I don't know what that was. Nick, ain't nobody. I don't know what kind of grown-ass woman get on here talking, trying to fight another woman online.
Yeah.
Like, she not even, I mean, she might be from the hood. We don't know. Tacky Tanya been tacky for a minute.
For a minute, yeah. She been running the blocks before us, so she got up. She was out here 15, 20 years before us running this shit.
With no shoes on, strong ass feet.
That's why she's so good at trekking. She's a professional trekker. Real shit.
And like, so that's why I say, like, all her hood stuff come from her mama's upbringing. Like, her mama wasn't shit.
Yeah.
And then, like, so when she come on and do all that bullshit online, it's just like, dude, like, where's the femininity in you? Like, you don't have none.
It's like none. This is crazy how so turned down they are. CJ done amassed about 50 million views on his Instagram in a fucking month. And Charlene took a month away after doing that weak-ass stalker skit. We thought she was going to get into that content. Look, even everybody even pulled back from talking about you because your content is boring. It's nothing in there. And look, you don't get, like, what's wrong with you, girl? Like, and now you come back talking shit again.
I get more views than her on Instagram.
Yep, sure do. And I'm just now starting to get, like, like used to my Instagram. You know how you won't be used to it, and I'll be forgetting. Like, it'll go a half a day, and I'm like, oh, I gotta get to my gram. I'm just now starting to get used to it. Like, no, gram, and start posting over there because I'd be neglecting my gram.
I'm finna start posting like a mug on there, but really my shit, cause I got all my shit going. Like, this summer's gonna be lit. Like, man, it's gonna be lit for a different reason.
Oh, I can tell shit. You'll be walking into a plaque damn near by this summer, nigga. Hey,
yeah, that's why I gotta put myself on there more, cause you know, I've been turning it up for, like, you know, the content.
Sure, and shit.
So it's just
you
like
motivated me. I said, man, you know what? Because I'm going to still talk about her. But I said, man, PJ made a slight left. You know what I mean? And that shit went big. Like, hold on, man. Let me open up a little bit. Because I got other channels that do that. But I'm like, nah, man, let me do that over here. I don't give a fuck if I post a video over here and it get 100 views. I'm going to keep going. Because no, bro, I didn't come over here to start talking about this girl. It was when she stopped letting that man see them twins. That was it. This channel was inspired by Kevin Samuels when he told the girly, ma'am, you're average looking at best. I said, oh, okay, you're average at best. I'm going to do that red pill content. And the shit just turned into, yeah, what the hell?
But I think, like, man on God, like, it's no convincing this stupid motherfucker to, like, do better.
Nope.
You can't convince her to be better, do better. Like, Man, I could be like, you wrong. She could be wrong all day. Nope, she not gonna listen to me. I don't care if she don't listen to me. But I just do it for the supporters, the people who gonna listen, be like, damn, they see it too. And I just make it funny at the same time. Like you know, we want her to do better, but this shit is funny. Like, let's be honest.
Yeah.
Like, watching a person crash out is hella funny, dog.
It's hella funny. And she really don't realize that, like, Charlene, if you just open up and be real, like you said, girl, I ain't worried about you, but look, you can't even, you too old to not be able to have some self-control. So that's like, cool, I'm gonna just keep using your own shit and flaws against you. Ain't nobody bullying you or degrading you. You bringing this to the World Wide Web, and we just commentary, pastiche, under the guidelines, using what you put out against you. That's all.
But she just said, she just said, I ain't going online and I ain't putting this shit out there. But then you come on and talk about CJ. What's she saying? Whatever she said, I don't know.
She said it right here. There it go. Right there.
I get to see it, so it's just like
right there.
Know how to react and know how to stand
cap
around, and you know, just not overreact and become just as angry and impulsive and regretful. Like, you know,
that's crazy. She'll say one thing and then the next 5 minutes do exactly what she says she's standing against.
But this, if your head wasn't so far up Mr. Arnett's ass, maybe we could get somewhere.
Oh my God!
What we doing, girl?
Yeah. So
what
now
we doing?
Implying that because of the situation is because CJ's hit. Oh, so now you're trying to make it and cloak that over that. Oh, okay. So just forget everything else that transpired.
It's CJ planted the damn drugs.
Damon's ass.
CJ planted the damn drugs to get Mr. Arnett caught up.
CJ flew all the way to Dallas or had one of his homies here, yo. You have to put this in your boy, right?
Blame damn CJ. Golly.
Blame CJ. Like, it's so pathetic that this is how weird they are. Nothing but lies is over there making a video with Damon Arnett's face and then CJ. But her title is basically saying that CJ is basically like always scared. You know, that narrative. It's not about this nigga's a crash out. This nigga's catching charge after charge. He's fucking a methamphetamine hit and a cocaine user. And he hit girly. Girly that he left the scene of the crash says she has neck pain, back pain, arm pain. She's never been the same since that crash. But he's just fat. And CJ's the motherfucking devil.
Hey, yo. But she, on this video, she showed some text messages. Tell her to show the whole text message and thread.
Yep, she won't. She won't do that.
Show us where you begging. She begging. Show the begging. All I want to do is show the begging, Royalty.
Yep.
Come on, man. Queen. Come on, Queen.
Yeah, come on.
Queens don't beg. She won't do that. Nope. You know why she won't do that? But she can show where CJ being nice. Don't be nice now. Show where he was being nice while he was begging.
Yep. Show why he's being nice. And she won't do that. She always show what, well, like we know always anyway.
We got receipts too. We got receipts. Beggar. Yep. She's a beggar and a nagger.
And a
nagger. Beggar and a nagger.
That's crazy.
A nagging beggar.
She's in love with a meth head. Straight method man. Bubblegum ass nigga.
500 likes and we're gonna show some receipts in this bitch.
Oh, 500 likes and we're gonna show some receipts like in this bitch. Just like that. Y'all heard him, man. He spoke. Put some respect on that.
Y'all better turn up. Y'all better turn.
Y'all seen what that man did in 1 month? Put some respect on that shit. That's genuine right there. Quit playing.
Man, I wanted to turn up tomorrow. I wanted to do it tonight, but I was like, man. Then I seen your notification going live. I said, oh, yeah, man, let me see if I can pull up.
I said, fuck it, I'm going to just do it, man. I wasn't going to go live, but I'm like, I'm going to just jump in for a minute and shit because I'm multitasking and shit. I'm editing, cooking, live and shit. Yeah, real shit.
I know you going hard.
Yeah.
Hey, shit, the grind don't stop.
Oh, man, hell yeah. Like, And like, hey. I'm about to convert my one channel. I don't want it to be I'm just Jason Reacts. I'm turning that shit into the Unbiased Truth Network.
Hey, review that with Des. Hey, come with it. Come with it, sister. Hey, man, I'm telling you. Look, man.
Dad slid through. That's what's up.
Look, man. Out of all this shit, CJ got on. He was capping with the you know what I'm saying, hopping the Lambo. I watched your video early. He was like, shit, how you drive off on him in a Lambo, have
Yeah,
mama come
real
back.
shit. And people try
You
to get
wanna?
mad, but he like, no, nah, he wasn't saying that rich people don't have problems neither. Look, he's going to court, rich, got money. He's just saying, I'd rather drive, like the girls are saying, I'd rather get cheated on in a Bentley. Oh, but now y'all don't get it. Oh, no, I don't want to be mad when the niggas say it. I'd rather drive off in this luxury than drive off dusty and broke. Still living in the Airbnb or wherever the hell you live. We're still waiting for you, Charlene, to show us the three cribs that you said you wasn't going to show after doing a house tour in $2 million cribs. We're still waiting. It's like 8 months ago. Biggest fall off in life. Y'all couldn't believe it. CJ would have had to beat me out of that house. I'm not leaving, nigga. What's wrong with you? I'm not leaving just to get with a meth head and a coke head? CJ's God then compared to this nigga.
Yeah. Man, hey, I hope she didn't get that Hellcat Durango in her name, because it looked like she
gonna
be dead.
Real shit. Hey, did you know this? Did you know this, bro? You look at this video right here, the scene of the crash when he hit Gurley. Did you know that Henry Ruggs, the same, his teammate, is his brother's there at that crime scene, is one of the ones that's saying that he was in place of, you know what I'm saying, Rico. That's crazy, bro. And just a couple months after that, his brother gets a vehicle. So all them Raider niggas was all on that same wave, driving under the influence, faded.
They was in Vegas, wilding. That's the wrong place to put an NFL team.
Hell yeah.
You got a bunch of young niggas out there in Vegas with money. Oh.
Yep. Henry Ruggs and Damon Arnett came in together, and they both got shipped out together. He's doing 3 to 4 years in prison, and your boy's out of the league first year. Unreal.
Over there messing with Danny Banks, getting them fat booty bitches, you know
Danny
what I'm saying? Stealing bitches' watches and shit.
Real tough.
A nigga a klepto, he a meth head, a coke head, armed and dangerous.
Armed and dangerous. He had her chauffeur in the Bentley while Iceland was sitting on his lap. Oh, but CJ's a cheater, but you allow his baby mom to sit on his cock while you drive the Bentley. Like, something is really wrong with you, girl. Whoa.
I don't know, man. If my kid was around this, I'd be telling the judge too, like, man, look at this shit.
Yep. I don't know how none of this ain't gonna come out to the judge. Like, look, Your Honor, he violated. They caught him with meth. Yeah, CJ, bro, this has to be told to your lawyers. I know they know. It'll be like nigga finding $100,000 of free money and walking past it. Nigga, I ain't even gonna doubt him. I know he's already pumping this to the lawyers. Like, look, this is her guy. They're around my kids. They be, you know, hell no. I don't know how that nigga not doing that.
And so that's why she don't be filming, because the nigga be around laid up in his drawers, you know what I'm saying, eating all the kids' snacks.
Yep.
Leon probably hate the nigga already.
Real like, man, shit. Because he don't involve Leon in shit. He only like the women. You notice that? He don't mention Leon. That nigga don't talk about Leon. He only like twin, best friend, the mom, and Tanya.
Leon ain't been in one rap song yet.
Hell no.
And they whack too. It ain't like you go do a platinum, nigga. Just put the nigga in something.
Yeah. Just put the nigga in something. That's crazy how you just threw your whole kid's life away. They had a promising future, man. The Wolfpack and Cool Kids. And you squandered that over feelings. You is a dumb bitch, bro. I can't believe it.
And they really turned up, boy. They turned up. They got the 1K likes, my nigga. They wanna see.
They turned up. Good look, my nigga. They turned up.
They wanna see them receipts.
Damn. Jason checked the last breakup between CJ and Royalty because she left the evidence on the bed and ran out the house. Oh shit. That's crazy.
Left the evidence on the bed. What evidence?
Yeah, hold on. Let me read that again. Jason checked the last breakup between CJ. So that was the second one when she went live and he was out of town. That was the last breakup. And she was U-hauling on live and leaving. Oh, I'm leaving. Like that, I think that was the last one. I might have to check with my producers.
She begged this. She begged.
Oh, yeah.
baby, please. She begged like Key Sweat.
Hell yeah.
She begged like Boys to Men on Although We Go.
That's crazy.
Come on, man. Hey, I tell you, the begging is real, man. Show the receipts, Royalty. I mean, I show the receipts. Show the text thread, Royalty.
Yep.
Since you want to show text threads, just be real.
Yeah, she cut it off. Show that. Yeah, you bad.
She don't want to. It's crazy how she do him, though. And then, like, one thing is, like, this man nothing but deserves his kids half the time. They was in the same city, same state at that time.
Yep.
And, you know, he put them in place to win. Yep. Now, had she done right, she could have put in there, hey, you need to pay for the kids to go full time.
Yep.
All month. If you're going to pay for all of it.
Pay for all of it. Yep.
But instead, she jumps ship and moves out of state. Like, man, how do you think that's helping your kids? Like, the ones that they have an active father in their life.
Yeah. She don't even care, bro. Like, how can you not? That's crazy. And you make it like somebody forced you. You just wanted to up Nike. Oh, that bitch got kids with them. Fuck that. I'm getting me something out of them. We know Tanya told you, look, you better get something out of this nigga. Don't just. Yeah, we know that game.
Yo, you can't up Nike. You can't even beat Nike. Why would you want to? How could you up Nike? Like, you got the man.
Yeah. He bought you all the jewelry. You had the crib. She had to watch that shit for 9 years. Yeah.
You can't up Nike, stupid. You got to up yourself, goofball ass.
What happened to Bossetta? Why ain't everybody and her supporters getting her up there? They'll buy her little kids toys that don't need it. Their dad will take care of them. But y'all ain't helping her with the real business. What happened to the 20 verse 1? What happened to, oh, she might do gardening? Man, you ain't doing shit.
Man, when she said gardening, I knew that was some bull crap, yep. Man. Like,
yep.
Come on, man. You got to get dirty. You got to get on your knees. You got to go search out for plants.
Yeah, something that you don't do.
She couldn't even search out for one thing green to eat all day.
Your real talk. Hey, thank you, Layla. Jason, Charlene took your advice on her skits. Yeah, I told her. I'm the one. Look, if she was smart, I told her to do this. Start a Royalty React channel. All she got to do is get an editor. Do 3 reactions a day. That nigga will edit them and post them, bitches. You can do reactions on us, on anything. Go back to where you came from. That's how y'all started, stupid. You don't think you cocksuckers, they will eat that channel up, but she's dumb. I will have a whole reaction channel on y'all goofies.
Bro, and that will do more because it's new and fresh content.
Thank you, bro. So see, we don't be over here just trying to down her. I told her we used to watch her as a family. Why don't y'all get that? It was only when she stopped letting that nigga see her kids and he got shot all up. What you mean? Yeah. I'm like the whole family at one point. When I used to watch them together, stupid, the kids, Lake Jalele, everybody that came over, we fucked with D-Lo. Anybody that came over, it was like we knew them because they in the video. So y'all not going to run that shit on us, nigga. Y'all watched her motherfucking just completely melt.
Well, I'm going to say this. She was broken by the time I met her. I mean, not met her, but got because she been cheat. They was like going getting cheated on, this and that. Then they had the twins still getting cheated on.
Yeah,
I was like, the bitch was nothing through. She was through with money.
She was through, yeah.
But I thought she was like still down. And I would see her how she would when her and Nike was going into it, and I was just like, man, this seems crazy. Like, and they were putting everything on Nike, and I was just like,
yeah.
So I was on Royalty side for a second. Not like on a side, but I was just like,
yep.
You know. Yep. And then it took a hot second. It took no time at all. And I was just like, nah.
Nah. Yep.
Something ain't right with this motherfucker. And sure enough, my intuition on dirtbag ass baby mamas.
Yeah, what came in your head?
I'm a professional dirtbag baby mama getter.
Getter, okay. Hell yeah. So he seen it. So he, that shit said, deep, 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 de
This shit ain't right. Like you keeping your kids away from a nigga that nigga what? Because I hadn't been watching them. I didn't watch them like daily because
yeah,
that wasn't my type of content. I watched Cars and shit.
Well, Cars and shit. Okay, so you was on 32s and that wave over that wave.
That's how I initially found
the other CJ. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So I found me from my son and shit, I think. Like one day, I think just naming them or seeing them one day, like, what's that? Oh, CJ so cool. Oh, dude, funny, man. Let me check this black family out and then just start watching them and shit.
I never watched family content or anything on YouTube.
Yeah, before. Me neither. Like, nope, me neither.
He was the first person I've ever watched with
like
a family.
Sports clips, sports centers, undisputed, just shit like that. Little quick little clips, sports, all that. Yep.
Yeah. And like, so I got invested, especially like the box opening. I'm like, I'm seeing the J's. And then I'm like looking at him buying these J's. I'm like, I know that nigga spent the bag on them. He should have just logged into Nike and won. Those was easy to win. I know he spent like $1,500 on those.
Yep.
I'm just looking at the shoes. I'm like, damn, but he got the whole family shoes.
The whole, and just to segue in on shoes, and look, man, can we put a reward? Hey, y'all, we need to put a reward out on all of the shoes and clothes. That, where did it go? Where did all of them box opening shoes and clothes go? They had Fendi, they had all that. Where is that at? She didn't throw it away.
No, she left it. She said she left it.
So she just left a trailer full of designer shoes, clothes, but took that big ass chair.
That I don't know. Yeah, I don't know why she took the chair. That was weird. Cause she was like, leave it all. But then you end up with the chair and be like, I want to sell the chair on eBay. Yeah, like, what? Like,
oh my God, you did not leave all, but they took the nameplates. Oh, but they all got their little nameplates though. You left all that designer, man. See, Kevin said, that's why he inspired me, because he said it. He said, a woman will blow up her whole family over some, like, yeah, over some mundane shit. You just blew up your whole life over emotions. Them emotions do this. You would have been cool in another 5 months. Shit, Michelle said she hated Obama for 10 years, nigga. Then he became the president. Now they up. Big books, rich. Nigga, she good, but she hated that nigga for 10 years, she said. Shit.
God damn.
Yep. She said, man, I just like my, she used the word hate. She went on that little, you know, sitcom, I mean, not sitcom, but podcast for like a week, telling her story, like, yeah, man. Said sometimes she would have to pay 80, 20. She had to take care of the bills. And then when he was up, she said, yeah. She said, just because she hated him for 10 years didn't mean she still didn't service and do things as a wife. But yeah, she said her and her husband, she said 10 years. I couldn't believe that shit. Like, what? Damn. And this is before he was like, the president. So nobody can say,
oh, he better work out, man. Nigga.
Like, damn. She from O Block, so we knew that. She from O Block, so hey.
She took all her stuff. She took all us. Now, yeah, Michelle was from the trenches. But you know, but what I think is I don't think Royalty had that example in her.
Yep.
To you know, not saying hold a man down, because like, man, listen. Cause she did kind of hold them down, but they used to hold it down, bum ass niggas that get out your life.
Yeah,
you hold them down for a little bit, then they go.
Then they go.
You ain't never held down a nigga, and he went up, and y'all went up, and then.
Yep.
These niggas, they used to get cheated on by broke niggas, where you can just leave and
just leave.
You ain't lose nothing.
Yep. But like you said, you ain't cut with a nigga that actually made, said his first YouTube check was 70 racks 7 years ago. Nigga, that was like 150,000, 200. Oh my God. Like, yo, she's tripping. Yeah. I would still be butt naked in the kitchen with a silk robe on making burning pancakes and shit because I'm trying to, you still want them, babe? You want them?
Drinking the Kool-Aid out the pitcher, nigga.
I'm cool, babe. You want them, babe? You want them? You want them? I'll be a Stepford bitch in that motherfucker right now. She left a nigga during the pandemic after the coronavirus. She's got to be the slowest bitch in America. I swear to God.
Jason going to be Melvin.
Hell yeah. Real talk, Melvin in that bitch. You want some sausage? Cheeks all out. I swear to God. You want some bacon? Nigga, real shit. Walk up to my stepson. Hey, nigga, you want some sausage and bacon with them eggs? Meat all out? Like, yo. Like, nigga, we comfortable, yo. You know what I mean? What the fuck?
Comfortable. Hey, Sit down, take a seat. Her breakfast gonna be ready in 20 minutes. It's like, nigga, what? Mama need a life too, okay? Man, oh man. Mama need a life too.
Mama need a life too. Oh my God. Then she think we forgot when she said Jalea was gonna have her quinceañera, and then they was in the nation. There was gonna be a part two. Never done none of those. Charlene, you think we be forgetting about this shit? What happened to her quinceañera?
Bro, I forgot she was Mexican.
Yeah.
That's why she was having a quinceañera. I was like, that didn't make no sense.
Yeah.
Because she's Mexican. That makes sense now.
Tell that, yeah. That's crazy. Man, Charlene is something else, bruh. Something else. She just lied.
I want to see, hey, y'all pull up the desk live tomorrow. The receipts is there. Don't. I want Charlene to show the whole, I'm going to give Charlene 24 hours.
Word.
To show the whole text thread.
The whole text thread.
Where CJ was being nice to her. Where CJ was like, you know what? You know, I just want things to work out.
To work
and she
out.
She was like,
let's just be cordial and left that nigga on red.
You got some slow music? Because I want to play some slow music. I want to tell y'all how she sounds like.
Slow music.
I'm gonna tell y'all how she
like the Titanic going down music.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
I'm gonna tell y'all what she said. I'm gonna tell y'all. Trust me, I got this etched in my brain. Of
damn.
Pages and pages and pages and pages of. But CJ, I know I'm only gone to Dallas for a few weeks. I'll be back. CJ's like, yeah, I really miss my twins. I wanna make this right so we can raise them together. We don't have to do all this traveling.
Oh yeah.
Please come back. We don't have to be enemies. And she's like, CJ, I know, CJ.
Oh, yeah.
But you just cut me off. You took everything from me. I had not a dime to spare.
Right.
Please spare me a dime. He's like, okay. But will you come back? Will you stay in Las Vegas?
Yeah.
Please stay in Las Vegas. And she's like, CJ, I'll do this for you. We have to make an agreement. I need a few dollars.
In the parking lots.
Of Winco. Give us just $7 to get them some cream. Please.
Still ain't get the cream.
Please. Hey, the begging is real, my nigga.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Hey, she ain't gonna show that.
Yeah, she's not gonna show that. Real shit.
What?
A creek beaver.
All I'm saying is, don't be coming on here showing messages of CJ trying to be a father,
yep,
trying to make amends and downing him. When he been doing that.
Yeah, right?
He been trying to do that. She act like it's just his first time. CJ want to be in his kid's life. Man, let the man be in his kid's life. Quit playing. Yeah. Why we going to court?
Yeah, he's one of them fun, goofy dads that'll play with the kids, tire them out all day. She don't get that. She lucked up and found a dad that want to be one of those goofy dads that want to be, CJ, come here, boy. She don't get it. You're blessed, actually, stupid. Damn, CJ's one of them goofy dads. What's wrong with you?
Man.
The funniest ones.
Hey, man, I'm going to tell you what. Playing soccer with my daughter is tough, my nigga. Because she kicked the ball here, there. But you know what? You got to get out there and do CJ would do it. And he gonna record it too, because he's gonna be like, well, we're gonna get this on camera, we're gonna get paid for it.
Yeah, it's gonna be a twofer. Yep, he's gonna do a twofer. Yep.
And dropping bags. I'm doing this shit for free, my
for
nigga.
For free. Hell yeah, nigga. Reaction time ain't the same. She kicking it down. Like, yeah.
At least he can edit it, you know what I'm saying? Make himself look good. Come on, man. Like the man put everybody in a position to win. Even now, the channel that she's on, she's in a position to win. She's still losing.
Yeah, she's still losing.
Not
if you
take,
give one of us that channel, oh my God, I'm going to go crazy.
My nigga, I'm a show my damn ass.
Hell yeah, I'm going to show my ass and damn near get the channel took. Like, y'all, I'm going to go nuts. Inherit a 1.4? Oh my God.
Uploads every day.
Uploads every day. Real shit. Like, yo, you got to airdrop them. I'm airdropping them three to you. Upload them. I'm working on three right now. It'll be like an assembly line of videos. Every time I'm done with three, I'm sending them three. He's knocking them out. Yep. I swear to God. Like how DDG said, they used to do 7 years ago. DDG said, man, he was loading like 15 videos. They just like, they didn't know how he did it. He was loading like 15 fucking videos a day, man. Just wham, wham, wham. That's before it was all this, you know, all these laws and, you know, they did all this community guidelines fully came and took over. So they had a lot of leeway, but still, damn.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, on God, like, you can see in my videos, I got like 1,000 videos. I got almost 2,000.
Yep.
It was times I was uploading 3-minute videos. I was just dropping clips all day. Like, cause I was like, man, I gotta boost some shit up. But yep. I still wasn't getting the views, but it was like some videos was hitting, some wasn't.
Yeah, that's what I tell people. Some hit, some miss. Yeah, just be cool with that. It's all good.
You just gotta go with it. Like I didn't stop for like three or four months straight.
Straight.
5 videos a day. And they was coming out 9 a.m., 12. 3.
Oh, yep.
5. Oh, 8. Nigga, like, every day.
Damn. Hell yeah.
Yeah, shit, man. Like, on the grind, because I knew, like, what I was thinking is, like, I was like, I just got to get out there. Sometimes you gotta really feel it. If you, because I wasn't really sticking to no niche. Like, when I got on the CJ So Cool shit, that was just a niche.
Yeah.
I was on this DJ on 32 shit, like clowning those folks. That's how the racism vlogs got on. I was clowning on him, and that was popping. And then the CJ, like the niches, I was catching niches by then. But before, I was just trying to find something that stuck.
Yeah, and what did you say about Kai? You said you posted a Kai video. What type of
I posted a How to Rob Cosinat.
Oh,
and that mother went crazy because he reacted to it.
Oh,
it's still on my channel right now, my nigga.
Oh, that's crazy. I'm like, man, he said he reacted to Cat. Oh, this nigga reacted to it. Oh,
no, I didn't. Yeah, yeah. So I basically was like, man, I was out selling turkey legs. I did my videos, my vlogs and shit from start to finish. Like every day I was recording my turkey leg journey.
Yeah.
And then like at the end of the summer, I made all the videos. Like I recorded all summer long. And then I just put the videos out like every couple of days. I put a new video out, but they was getting like 20 views.
Yeah,
I'm like, man, this some bullshit. I'm like, man, I could just talk about some bullshit and get this shit cracking.
And get this shit cracking real shit.
And I just started a How to Rob. I was like, nigga, I started How to Rob Mr. Organic, How to Rob Western Chaplin, How to Rob, nigga.
Which you would just tell stories on like how to rob them?
No, nigga, I would just be like, I'ma rob you. Like, because I watch these fools.
Oh.
So I would talk about the shit I see them doing, talk what they talk about, where they be. And,
oh, like that, yeah, like, oh, that's crazy.
And I was talking about, like, this nigga Cosinat, I just, somehow I knew he lived in Brooklyn or something, and he had a mouse in his house and some shit, and I talked about robbing this nigga. I said, I wouldn't rob you because, nigga, you had mice in your house. Nigga, you probably ain't got shit. And he was like, how does this nigga know this? He got to be a fan.
Like, how did this nigga know this?
But that's just random shit that I watched of his that he talked about it, and I just talked about him, how I want to rob him. And this nigga was hella mad when he reacted to it. He was like, nigga, you gotta watch it. It's on my channel.
Oh, I'm gonna watch it. When you mentioned that, I said, I'm like, what do you mean, Castanati? Oh, I'm gonna definitely watch that shit.
I got my actual video and then his reaction to it. Shit is crazy.
Oh, I'm gonna watch both of them shits because I know, like, yo, that's crazy.
And that's when my shit was, and that shit blew up. And it was just like, man, nigga, they don't wanna see, like, the good wholesome shit. They wanna see.
Nope, Star always tell me they come here for the bullshit, man. Your boy from the Star Report from way back in the day, and he got his channel still popping. Star, that's what he say. That, man, they want the bullshit. And Charleston say it. When he was being all wholesome with the bow tie on the internet, trying to be wholesome, nobody did shit. But when he created that ignorant-ass character, oh, nigga, look at him now. The nigga just came out with a kid's book. Yeah, because niggas want that bullshit.
Mm-hmm. Hey, but check this out. Cat Williams on that bullshit on Shannon Sharp. Video 60 million. This nigga was dropping knowledge on Joe Rogan. Man, niggas ain't fucking with that shit.
Ooh, yup.
Watch that shit, dog. That shit is, you gotta be.
I saw a little bit of it when he was telling Joe Rogan. They was talking about something about, what was he saying about, it's not cool to say something black people, and they was saying something discussion.
Oh, I think it was about eat chicken or something.
And yeah, eat like, chicken, and he said it ain't real. Like, yeah, he wouldn't get mad if he said, like, white people like some shit. Yeah,
like white people like spaghetti. Would you?
Yeah,
like,
spaghetti. I watched that part. I'm like, oh, I gotta spin back on.
Now watch the whole shit. It's 3 hours long, but it's like, nigga, like for the first 2 hours, you like, you'll be intrigued by the shit that they talk about. Like
they talk about, yeah.
It's real deep. It's real deep, but it's far off from the nigga shit.
Yeah, like, far off from the nigga shit. Yep.
So it's like, you know, you go like, we only intrigued by that, not by the bullshit. Yep. But that shit right there, it intrigues a whole different audience. But you gotta have.
Like you said, look, it ain't explosive how it was over at Shay Shay. Yeah. But that shit goes crazy over there at Joe Rogan. That shit gonna touch places that nigga and people that don't even be on this side gonna see that shit.
Yep.
What they call the dirty section of YouTube, the dirty section.
Anyway, fuck royalty. No, I'm just playing. We gotta get it back cracking. that's what they came here for. They wanna hear us talk shit about her. But I don't really wanna talk shit about her. Just wanna tell her.
Yep.
Fumbled on the 1 yard line.
Yeah, you fumbled, and I've been told her, like, if you just be transparent, like, nobody ain't chasing you or worried about you. Why you act like you this secretive, hard to get, like, girl, don't, like, listen to what people saying. We said some real shit to your goofy ass.
Mm-hmm.
Always want to be negative and think people, then she get into this mode right here that, you guys, they always get into the hardcore royalty, and then every other week, she'll get back into this damsel in distress, this little shrunken valet.
In full throttle, in 4K, as of now, is.
Then she said on this video, as if we really wanted them back, she said, you know, guys, will we ever get back? No, guys, you know, that's dead. That's over. You know, no one can eat at the table that I sit at. Like, Charlene, you know fucking well that that's over. We already been over. Knew that was never coming back. Quit. Why you keep trying to, like, this girl, man.
Hey, what you think about her telling her supporters that she don't like them being, she don't like being the main characters on they channels?
Oh, she said she don't like being the main characters on their channels.
Yeah, on her supporters' channel. She don't want to be the main character on their channel.
No more. Like, won't they talk about other stuff? She don't want to be the main-driven focus. Oh, shit.
Yeah, hey. She said, fuck them. I'll fuck them toys. I'd send them back.
Oh, shit. See? She's heartless, man. She's one of them. She's a fake. She's one of them fake Mexican Puerto Rican princesses shit. Think she's a, you know what I mean, a cartel queen and shit. Fake cartel queen.
What's her name?
Griselda.
Griselda.
Yeah, Griselda. Who the fuck she thinks she is, man? So,
yeah, but it's because she was like, it's whack, it's lame, you know what I'm saying, and this and that to make a whole hate channel and all this stuff, and it's just like, yo, who are you talking about? Because that's all your supporters talk, every one of your supporters, every one of them, ones. They don't talk about nothing but you and CJ so cool. So
yep.
Help me understand what you're talking about.
Yeah, like, look, real quick, I'm going to show you. I'm going to show her real quick. Look, this is all they talk about. They go, look, I got it pulled up. Their channels is about nothing else. And they be trying to say, you, girl, I got 5 channels that's about all different shit. What is you talking about? Look, they don't, I wouldn't want to be y'all focal point neither. Like, look, that's all y'all talk about. Look, that's it. Like, where's, y'all do know there's a big internet out here, right?
A huge internet.
What is wrong with people just to stay stuck on that? Yo, there's so many stories and y'all not. There's a Snapchat, there's a TikTok. Y'all goofy. And just stay on this same content right here, worried about Charlene. You know what I'm saying? And that's coming from the advocate side. Now, of course, the ones that got more to dig on her and try to correct her from, you know, that I don't even do that sad shit no more. But the people that's talking against it, yeah, but these is coming from your advocators. That's talking about you and shit. The fuck?
They sit on this motherfucker every day. CJ did this. Now they talking about CJ lost in court. CJ, like.
Look, here it go. I'm so scared of Swab. Look, let me turn that off. Nothing but the truth. Put this weak-ass video up with the narrative. I'm so scared of Mr. Suave. And then she put that up. Just corny as hell, bruh. Like, you don't got nothing else to talk about?
CJ is the only man in history that would drag the mother of his kids to court.
The only man in history that would drag the mother of his kids to court when the bitch was the one that said, you take me to court, CJ.
Wait a minute. Do she not want him to... What?
You heard that?
Let me. What person would not want to take their baby mama to court?
Thank you.
To see their kids.
They're weird. She really said that, bro. Look. Look, let me hurry up because they ignorant and weird. They'll try to strike you.
What you mean is taking too long, CJ? You drag her to court and you complain about seeing her. You complain about you dishing out too much money. You the one took her to court. You know, you should have thought about all this. Then you complaining, and keep complaining. Ain't you just text Royalty the other day?
What? Oh, my. This girl, I'm gonna stop it real quick because they... Yeah, they're weird. I don't know how they like to play that strike game. So I'm a
That is crazy.
Ain't that crazy? Look, and these are the people that advocate for her. So if your advocators don't even got the brain to help you, how can you ever be helped? Like,
never.
Yo. See, she's how these arenas are? Look how they are. These 304 mud roaches. You can. She told this nigga to take her to court. Goofy.
Did she? Well, in really? 3D, oh, in 4K, God. What is it? In 4K, she told
me. That's crazy. What else she say? Look.
Other than you said that you want to be civilized, you want to co-parent, you don't want to be. So why would you go to the internet and post this video?
Her posse, waiting on me, cursing me out right in front of the court. It shouldn't have been over. Starting to think they got something they just want to see.
They do.
Chatting to throw shades at Royalty because I guess Royalty went to the courtroom and said that CJ allowed the kids to do whatever they want.
Just weird. Look, just weird, bro.
Man, yo, man. Hey, you know what? This is what I talk about. People don't mind their own damn business. Like, if you a real parent, trust me, there's some real parents out here.
Yeah.
Okay. When you are dealing with your kids and you in real life with your kids, there are things, they got a life out here. So there's ways you have to talk to your kids nowadays.
Hell yeah.
Well, not even nowadays. Back then, there was a way to talk to us and tell us how to do things.
Yep.
But I think a lot of things were so hidden so much back then because we had parents in the church real bad.
Oh, yep.
Grandma's was really involved.
Grandma's was really involved. You wasn't going to embarrass her.
So now it's like, okay, you got to talk to your kids a different way because the world is different. So yep. Things are different. So we didn't have social media.
You're right. Like you said, if me and you wanted to connect, I had to go over ASPJ here. I had to actually commute to you. Now I could just wham. Hey, oh yeah, bro on. Hey, bro, what's up? I'm about to slap. Yeah, nigga. And then I could say that to 10 other of my homies that next minute. We would have to all group up and walk over. PJ Crib, Jason Crib, my nigga Mark Crib. All right, now it's 3 of us. All right, y'all, let's go to James Crib. Yeah, nigga.
Yeah. So, the world is different because like just how you said we had to link up, that one person that had to walk home at night, we had to, we either had to walk halfway, and then run the opposite.
Like, damn, I'm gonna walk you halfway, bro, and then dart back.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Because these kids ain't gotta go through that, because they some of them don't even come outside. They could talk to each other and congregate on the phone and do everything they gotta do.
This is how you're right. My son got a homie in Florida. They're streaming buddies. They got music together, bro. He's from Florida. He never met him in his life. They're like, I told him, like, yo, when I get a chance, I'm going to really try to connect y'all, because this is like a real internet friendship. They created music together off of GarageBand, bro, and they not even, he's from Pittsburgh, and he from Florida. Like, yo, this is amazing. And they really got like a real chemistry. Like, they cool. Making music together, got the album cover where it's split face of him with the Florida side and then the Pittsburgh side where it's all snowy and shit. Amazing, bro. Like, this shit is crazy. 13-year-olds and shit.
God, man, see, it's different. So when you have to raise these kids, you talk to them different. You like the social media, what is it called when you do so? The trending,
yeah,
the trends,
the trend, yeah.
You stay up on the trends with your kids because you want to be in tune with them.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. So how can you talk about how a person is with their kids when they doing everything that everybody else is doing with their kids
with their as friends. Yeah.
Man, I don't see. I understand you don't want the kid cussing.
Cool.
But golly, man, it's like they not the first kid. Nigga, when the kids really be away from their parents, they cussing.
Yeah, they cussing. And that's what they would got mixed up. When we used to just say to Jaleah and all that cussing, like, come on, man, y'all think I'm really naive? Come on, man. I'm a fucking felon that was bad as hell in school, cussing, stealing. No, but I'm just saying, when you going to let it negligently just come on the internet, oh, I'm going to strike you for it. You could have curved that. So it's like, oh, okay, cool. They just going to let it run loose on the net? Oh, well, fuck it. I'm going to talk about it. I know my son and them be cussing, like you say. Ain't nobody tweaking on that shit, really.
But them doing it on the internet is like us doing it in front of our teacher.
Yeah.
Oh, you gonna cuss at the teacher?
No,
exactly. Mama gonna whoop that ass.
Nope, you're not. And in church with your auntie, you're not gonna be cussing out front of the church while y'all just waiting for prayer service to start. Yeah, you're not. They try to excuse and knock off that whole layer right there. And that was a great teacher analogy. Like, you're definitely not going to be cussing in front of your teachers. Miss Sand Glover and Mr. Carmichael, you not. Real shit.
Hey, we had SWATs back then, too.
Yup. I swear, our music teacher was allowed. He had this little pole. It was just this big, like the remote control. We was in music class. He would say, don't sing yet. Listen. So if we would not listen, this is in like 1991. He was allowed to take that little wood thing and say, bang, right on the top of your head. Just a little tap. Boop. I watched my boy have to pull his pants down and get beat in front of the class like it was a fucking project. Like it was a project where you get up and show, like, look, I got G.I. Joes. He really had to sit in front of the class, pull down his pants to his tighty whities. I remember his name, my boy Charles Coaston, and got his ass whooped. Charles Coaston. To this day, I remember him from the second grade. His name is Charles Coaston. Yep. Charles Coaston. He know if he see this, I'm telling the truth. And his mom whooped his ass in front of the class, bro. Couldn't believe it. Couldn't believe it.
Bro, I got my ass whooped in front of music class. My mom whooped my ass in front of music class. I was showing out in front of in my science class, and knowing my damn science class teacher know my mama.
Oh, and gave you whelps. Whelps your shit all up.
Woo-wee.
Yep. Said, oh, okay, you want to act out? Oh, okay. Whooped his ass.
Check the cash out, bro.
That's why we got layers to us from that generation, man. This generation is so hollow and goofy.
But now we can see Charlene never got that ass whooping in class because, I mean, unless Tanya put them hands on her. Allegedly.
Yeah, she did, because remember, she threw her out to the wolves. She threw her out to the wolves, and that's how Jamie got all in them creek meat.
Got out of microwavable.
Yep, that's how he got all in that, hers is baked macaroni because she grown. and then there's the microwavable, and then there's the little one. She got a Lunchable.
No, yeah, she was microwavable when she had Jaleah. Oh, yeah, that's how she
was, she was microwavable.
It she came threw out her. Threw her out to
leave the little ones in for 3 minutes. She pulled it out at a minute and a half. She's supposed to leave it in for another minute and a half. She pulled her microwavable out a little too early. You're right. It had three kids. But did y'all ever answer this? Do we know if all three of them kids are biologically Jamie's? Now we know Nation is. Nation is that nigga's twin.
Nah.
I don't know about the other two.
Leon looked like her.
Yep. Leon looked like her. I can't see him in Jaleah and I can't see him in Jaleah. I promise I can't. But if somebody can, just say it. I ain't saying that to be funny. I'm just saying, like, do we really know? Yeah, because I ain't saying it to be funny. Oh, they look like her. Oh, I see. She said they look like her. I ain't tripping. I know Nation looks just like that nigga.
Man. Listen. Them kids was doomed from the beginning.
Yep, because she threw them out.
Two parents that ain't shit.
Yep. And tried to lie. She tried to lie and say that she was always the one with the kids. But we like, hold on. How was you the one with the kids? And you said you was always the one working. That means baby was the 90% parent and you was the 10%.
She was working. She was taking care of kids. She was changing bottles, birthing the babies, changing diapers, and going back to work. Like, bitch, did you sleep?
Yeah, bitch, did you sleep? How you doing that?
She went to work, bent over.
Right, you was at Jamie's mom's crib, and they was taking care of you because Tanya threw your little fast ass out. Get the fuck out. She threw your little fast tail hussy ass up out the crib.
Fast. Just fast.
And had three babies like this. You see how fast she was. Damn, I see you had one, fell off, tripped off. Okay, you didn't wait, nigga. She in a whole crib. She don't got to listen to no parents. Man, Jamie was up there like this, all in that roast beef.
I mean, at least she had the same baby daddy, allegedly.
Yep, I'll give her that. At least she had the same baby dad, allegedly.
You know,
all these, we have the meat.
Sometimes these chicks like that, man, you know, these hood chicks that get pregnant young, they had a first baby, then that dude dipped.
Yeah,
but Jamie at least was there. You know what I'm saying? We don't know the full story.
Fighting. We seen him fighting for Jaleah 2 years ago on her 15th birthday when we watched. We know this is an MO of Charlene. CJ had to do the same thing. Bought that cake for him. Never was able to give it to him. And Jamie 2 years before that or a year before that done the same thing when he was in the little grocery store. Hey Jaleah, I love you. You know, daddy always love you, baby. I got your cake. Yeah, and to this day, we still don't know. This bitch is just the Black Widow that bite off your head after you hit it.
Yeah, bro. I never understood this, man. If I see a chick that's keeping her kids away from their baby daddy, I ain't messing with her, dog.
Yeah. Yep. She'll shoot you in your head while you sleep. Real shit.
Yeah.
She's one of them.
I read because they out here. You know, you won't know until you know. But then, like, Oklahoma's small, so you kind of can know.
Yeah, Pittsburgh's small, too.
Yeah.
Pittsburgh only got 300,000 in our per square. Yep, 300,000. Yeah, small.
Yeah, so once you figure out, like, oh, no, that ain't going to work, big dog.
Yep.
Yeah. So I know that, like, when CJ met her and he thought that, well, from her telling and from listening to Tacky Tanya, well, he wasn't doing this and he wasn't doing this. So CJ's like, you know what? I'm going to come in. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to come in. I'm going to change this. He came in. He was, I'm going to take the kids to school. I'm going to, you know what I'm saying? Show you how, like, because I got to really. I ain't got really shit going on, but I'm going to do it.
You
know?
And that's the game. Yeah, like this guy really put on for you and you just dismiss all that. That's why they say, man, being stepdads. You know, I had a stepdad. I know how that shit is. I mean, we was disrespectful. Nigga, fuck you. You ain't my dad. Nigga, fuck you. Like, yeah, there was no benefit to this nigga for that. Not that in his heart he might have benefited. Like, man, I love them. You know what I mean? But was there a real benefit for this nigga? No. We was disrespectful. My mom had eight of us. We was running over that nigga. Well, my fault. That's my six brother and sister's dad. Me and my oldest brother got our dad. So my mom got two baby dads, my six siblings' dad, the one that got killed from Chicago, and my brother and my dad. So that was our stepdad, so I used to disrespect him. Nigga, no favor. Here, nigga, give him weed, he give me weed, steal shit from him, straight disrespectful, nigga. And look, when it's over, there's nothing you can say. CJ, don't all that put in and all that work, potty training, it's just, nope. They don't fuck you. That we remember him calling him daddy, daddy, when you getting fucking shoes and shit. Now this nigga scum. See? No benefit. No fucking benefit. So I ain't trying to discourage nobody and saying that there's not no good stepdads and situations out there. There is. But I'm just saying, man, directly there's no benefit when it's over. They just do you like, fuck you. It's over. We don't care.
But when they mama is a Charlene, it's like, they gonna follow. If the mama would have been like, nah, y'all respect him, or not even, y'all don't have to be like call him dad anymore, but yeah, like the nigga did like change our lives for a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Bit. Like, let's have some type of respect for the man, like, yeah, not, she don't have to, but like, y'all, this is not y'all's fight, yeah, this is not y'all's argument. Y'all stay out of this because, first of all, stay your black ass in a kid's place. One. Two. He never did wrong to any of y'all.
Nope.
So.
And what's sad is the only thing they can combat back with, when Rico just got caught with all them guns and drugs, the one thing that they can say was, oh, but CJ pulled his gun out 6 years ago in front of his daughter. Like, what? I'll pull my gun out every day in front of my kids. If it's a threat, fuck you talking about. What do you mean?
Because that's why that shit didn't go through. Like, it some shit happened.
Yep, that's why he wasn't able to legally. Yep, you're right. That's why it didn't go through, and he's still a legal gun holder. Yeah. Yep, and that's the only thing they could bring up. But once again, this man got caught. Like you said, I'd have stuck that meth in my booty before I let the cops get it. And I'm not saying pause. I'd have been like, ooh, and been tweaking, nigga, but they wouldn't have got it.
Well, spit on it first.
Yeah, real shit. I'd have swallowed that motherfucker, done 10 things.
All right, now.
Before I, right? What the hell? Nigga, I'd have crumbled that bitch into 1,000,000,000 little crumbles and just wiped it out on the floor, whatever.
Hey, then you got to sit there and be still so you don't, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. He'd be like, you okay? Yeah.
That's crazy.
Hey, man, real niggas do real shit.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, if you ain't stuff a dime back, you ain't been in the hood long enough, bro. You know what I'm saying?
For real. I used to see Crips pull a whole 40 bags of rock, 40, 20 rocks in a bundle out of their booty cheeks. Whole bundle of rocks, just boop, because the task force used to come around. And they was heavy in Pittsburgh because we actually had the cops to show what you're going to do when they come for you. Bet they actually filmed several scenes here. So, nigga, they had cops, the series, actually in our neighborhood chasing all the Crips. So the task force was grabbing niggas. So niggas would stick it up their ass and swallow it. But they had this chocolate milk stuff that they would make you drink that would make you spit up. So niggas would spit all their rocks right up. They force you to drink this chocolate drink. Yep.
Bro, when I was locked up, my cellie used to bring in stuff. So my mom used to come visit me every month.
Yeah.
And drop off tobacco where my cellie could pick it up because we worked off the thing. So he'll roll the tobacco up, and the tobacco, it'd be compact tight, but it'd be like this, like quarter size, but be like an inch long.
Yeah.
He put four of them motherfuckers in.
Four of them.
Four. And nigga, one time we was getting searched, and I was like, damn, I know he brought some shit in. He was like, I was like, damn, where's the stuff at? He said, in my stomach. I said,
stomach. Proud as hell, like, they ain't getting this.
Oh, God. I was like, that was a monster.
Hey, Hector wasn't playing in my stomach.
He said, he wouldn't pull them thing out there. That's why I ain't smoked tobacco when I was locked up. Yeah, real shit.
We made the wine and everything. I made wine and everything when I was locked up. Real shit. Tobacco we had come. I had actually, when I got arrested, I had like a 1.5 wrapped up in my shoe inside of a joint. I ain't know I was gonna get arrested that day, but when they grabbed me, I tucked it in my shoe. ain't know I was going to be in this bitch for a year. Man, I had that in my shoe the whole year. I ain't smoking. Like, fuck that. I'm waiting until I get out. Because I always thought I was going to get out. But my bonds were so high, and I had a detainer on me, I couldn't move. So a year later, I finally got out, went to court, gave me 10 years probation. And nigga, that first day, I pulled that joint out, and it was up. Real shit. But when I got home, my niggas had big weed for me anyway. I just wanted to let me take that bus ride home. I ain't want nobody to pick me up. I've been in this building for a year, nigga. I want to get on the bus and just take slow ride home. Yep.
Hey, man. Shit, boy.
Damn.
They don't know. Yeah, they don't know. That's a real nigga story. That's why crash dummies go to jail for a pill. Nigga, one pill. Goof ass nigga.
Goofy nigga for a pill. What?
Come on, man.
Nigga, what pill? Huh? Pill? What pill, officer?
That would have popped that mug.
Yeah.
Be sweat.
Right? Nigga, long as they know Fetty or nothing, and it's just a regular that I know, this is a cool pill that I know what it is. Man, what pill? I promise you'll never find this.
I'ma just tuck it in my side. Oh, red ass nigga. I'ma just tuck my chain in.
Unbelievable. The cop said, I mean, you know, man, you're just an idiot. We saw you drop earlier a rolled up dollar and your girlfriend picked it up. He said, man, you think we're stupid? We know what's going on, man. You're down here at Miami Beach. He said, man, come on. Like, so the cop already knew, look, man, this is Miami Beach. I don't feel like writing no reports. Okay, I know they lit. We ain't gonna mess with like no first level shit. It gotta be turned up. Cause you ain't gonna just let a nigga go. You see what you just saw. Watch him pick it up. He's like, no, it's 90 degrees. I don't care. But when they saw this goofy later, he's like, oh, no, pull it the fuck over, dummy. We let you go earlier. And I feel the cop, dummy. And now you get caught with another half a gram. What's wrong? You the grant? Like, how dumb are you, my nigga? My nephews and them be moving shit, and they don't get caught with half a gram. Niggas move weight. Fuck you talking about?
I don't think I ever rode with, like, nothing like that. Like,
nope.
Everything I rode with was usable.
What's usable?
I'm gonna get rid of it. Like we ain't gonna be riding around with it, kicking it.
I use this. This is my self care package. Real shit. I'm not riding around with
it. Get rid of it,
right? Oh, I use this, officer. Yep. Look, I got all my roll ups, my hair. Yep. Real shit.
So that's. I think dude is just, man. He just green to real. He just want to have it to have it, man. I don't even think it's just like,
yep.
And to be riding around at 3 a.m., my nigga, use a crash dummy, nigga. Yep. Nobody rides around at 3 a.m. dirty.
And then know that you don't got a license. That's a real crash
dummy.
Yeah, you know you don't got L's. You already look weird. Yeah, you real goofy. Riding around, oh, hell, Dallas too? What?
Yeah.
Down there? Oh, hell no, nah, nigga. They ain't with that.
Nah, not in Dallas. Houston, you could get away with it.
Yup.
But Dallas
said that. Charleston said that. He said, nigga, they'll take you to jail for a clip. Like, what?
He said,
but Houston, you can get away with that shit in Houston. It's cool. It's more lenient. Charleston definitely said that. Don't fuck around in Dallas, nigga.
Don't fuck around in Dallas. They'll take you. And then Dallas got a 24-hour jail. So, nigga, like, or they at least they did back when I was shaking and moving. So, like, nigga, if you go to jail, nigga, you going to see a judge that night.
Yup, like a city judge. That's what they call in Pittsburgh. Yeah. It's the night judge. It used to be an actual judge, but now she's on a monitor, or he's on a monitor now. So you get to, they can actually be in bed or, you know, somewhere in a room. Yup, that's how it is now. You get a digital judge, so you get to see them a little bit after you get your fingerprints and you go through them little couple cells and wait. They give you that little punk-ass bag. Then you finally, like 7 hours later, you finally get to see the judge to see if you're going to get a OR or a little bond.
So that's how it used to be. So you could really get out on a weekend, but it's busy though. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, but I thought that shit was pretty dope because I ain't never, like in Oklahoma City, nigga, you get caught on a Friday, nigga, you're there till Monday.
Oh, shit. So nigga, you're there till Monday.
Monday.
You're sick. You know, your whole weekend's done.
Done.
Damn.
Hey, and then, And Cleveland County, which is south of the city, nigga, if you get a public intox is 12 hours in a detox center in the city, Oklahoma City. But Cleveland County, nigga, you got to see the judge on Monday. So, and that's where the OU campus is.
Oh.
So, nigga, you'll miss a whole weekend of partying, nigga, if you catch a public intoxication. And they take everybody. They love picking up drunk people. Damn. In Norman. Because it's $175. And then you're going to pay the jail fees. Yep. On top of the... That's how they make their money, because it's a bunch of drunk kids.
Oh, yep. And just be rounding them motherfuckers up like cattle. Hell yeah.
Like cattle. Killing us. Oh, shit.
Damn. See, we lose out in things like where we got to get inspections and inspection. Like Ohio and Cleveland, they don't need them little stickers in their windows. See, we do. You got to get annual inspections. And if you got one light on, you won't pass inspection. I'm like, come on, my nigga. Damn.
My nigga, it's a Cutlass. Come on, what you say?
They be tripping, bro. The fuck? So every state got some goofy shit that be like, damn, yeah. And I wish we ain't had that, or I wish we had that.
Yeah, we don't got inspections. Texas, I think they did away with inspections at Texas, but Oklahoma, we don't got inspections no more. We did away with that.
Oh, see, we do, man. You got to get your car inspected. If the police pull you over and your inspections pass, they can be like, oh, you got it. Like, man, get the fuck away from me, bro. What is 2024? Inspections?
Nah, niggas got cameras. I was driving my Camaro, and I got a ticket in the mail. I got a ticket in the mail. Said I ain't had no insurance. I'm like, my nigga, what?
You like, nah.
What it do, Jay Wolf?
Jay Wolf, what it do?
I had to call him. I was tripping because I was like, man, I got insurance.
Yeah, hell yeah.
So it's just like, damn, we got cameras now? Just writing niggas tickets.
Just writing niggas tickets. You think you got away and them niggas spin the block on you. Like, nah, nigga. That only used to happen when you like go through an easy pass. Now it's regular shit. Damn.
Nigga, a regular street light, my nigga. That's why I was like, damn. And I knew where I was going. Yeah. So I was just like, that's crazy that they would do that. But I had insurance, but the insurance company, they kept getting hits from my insurance company. So it was like a glitch in the system. So I was like, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's what they got up here now in Monroeville, because our malls got shot up by some nigglets like 2 years ago. So they got these special cameras that'll, of course, license plate readers, but them shits will follow you. So if you do any shooting in Monroeville, nigga, them shits will follow you too. They can't follow you no more. So you can't shoot in Monroeville no more.
Yeah. I forgot what they called, but yeah. They got them everywhere now.
Oh, they got them everywhere.
Yeah, because they got them. They got them in rural areas out here now, because motherfuckers stealing cattle and shit like that. Yeah, it's crazy because they could follow you. That's how they caught the FBG duck killers.
Oh, nigga, that's right. You know, that's right.
They got them from the projects. Every
I said it was like a digital puzzle. I said, man, if they ever get caught, I bet that shit be like boop, boop, boop. Boop, and that shit was a digital puzzle.
Yeah, like, that shit crazy.
That's crazy. All these Ring cameras, man, I won't throw a rock at a nigga's crib. I'm glad my criminal days are 20 years gone, nigga. I'm happy. Hallelujah.
As soon as my shit go off, I'm like, nigga, who is that?
Ring camera now, nigga.
Amazon. Okay, Amazon, nigga.
They said out of 10 cribs, six to seven cribs have Ring cameras on them. You can't even walk down your block without being 8 cribs unseen you. How you gonna go do something? You gotta go through the woods in the back of your crib to lead a block if you wanna do some dirt. Every camera saw you, nigga.
Nah, I see you from all angles of my shit. Yep. Backyard, front yard, all that shit.
Oh, you see, you can't even leave the crib. I didn't leave. Well, who is this nigga right here with the red hat on the white shirt? That's you, right? Yeah, I wouldn't do a crime in this generation, nigga. I'm good.
Yeah, all angles of my crib.
Hell yeah.
Backyard, like neighbor's DJ yard.
Academics. He said he got that $20,000 camera system like DJ Academics, nigga. Academics said this shit is unreal. You a squirrel move, motherfucking, is picking you up.
And my shit got like 10 terabytes of recording. And
so your shit's like a convenience store, motherfucker. You could get shit from last Thursday.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Last month.
Yeah.
Well, let me see on Thursday. What was let me see if some weird shit was going on last two Thursdays ago. Oh, what's this? Hell yeah.
Let me see. I ain't going to show you my cameras, but I'm going to show you my
Yeah.
playback.
That's crazy. Somebody said, I'm looking on Fab cameras right now with the blick. Hell yeah, like Scarface, T6, 6. Hell yeah, like this.
Waiting all right, so it's showing. Oh, you can see those yeah. those lighting up. It's just going to March 2nd, but it go February. February is lit up. Damn. Yeah, February is lit up. Like, everything is still recorded.
Everything's still recording.
Yeah. Yeah, everything.
This nigga got the Walmart cameras with the little blocks that go over your face.
Yeah, everything's still lit up, nigga. Everybody, we ain't playing with you, nigga. Pull up if you want to.
Pull up if you want. You got the Walmart camera system.
And it goes off every...
Hell yeah, because I set my little one in the proximity. If you move in this one little spot, you got to come up my steps. It's going to let off this siren, like the like rear, just a little signal. Like, yeah, hold on, nigga. It might be a raccoon or a cat sometimes set it off.
Hey, and I ain't gonna tell them. I'm gonna tell you my secrets on the left. I got another camera that move. I can move.
Yeah.
It's a whole separate system, but it's
yeah, I got this little fake dummy one too. That's just a pump fake, like the store one with the blinking light. I got a dummy one in between my other cameras. That's real shit.
Yeah, shit, man, boy. Man, you gotta be laced up these days.
Hell yeah.
Hey, shit, man.
You gotta be laced up these days. My shit's Jawa. Hell yeah, my shit's called Jawa.
Anyway. Dude, we done turned up on the real.
Hell yeah, and turned up on the fucking.
I've been wanting to rock with you because I'm telling you, nigga. I was gonna come on and do this shit tomorrow, but I was like, man. I just rock out.
Just
like,
rock out real shit. That's what's up. Hell yeah. Yeah. And I'm glad I ain't have to do it by myself because them last 3 days in a row I did it. Nigga, I'm sweating. Look, I ain't have to sweat this time. I ain't have to tell big jokes and shit. It was nice and comfortable. Real shit.
Hey, we got a killer, man. We got to keep it lit, big dog, man, all the time, man.
Hey,
shit,
that was dope real quick between you and Big Wave God, too, yo. Real shit. I like Wave God, man.
Yeah, man. Shit, man. Hey, man, listen, we here to grow. We here to introduce everybody to all our audiences.
Right. Nobody. If a nigga needs some help or something, ain't nobody going to trip. Like, yeah, ain't nobody tripping, bro. Like, what's wrong? We here to help. We here to inspire. Like, yeah. What the fuck?
Yeah. And motherfuckers that grind, it's a no-brainer, man. Just rock with people, man. Just be a genuine person, man. I don't look for nothing from it, but I see he's a great guy, man. And I was just like, I'm going to pull up on him, man. I hit him up. I was like, man, I'm out there. So, you know, and we kept it under wraps. We just bust with it. So it's crazy because people got to understand, man. YouTube is a great platform, you know what I mean?
Yep.
You just got to use it. You meet people. Some people, listen, you ain't got to be friends with everybody,
nope.
That's just the thing. You're not going to be friends with everybody.
Yeah, for real.
But when you do meet genuine people, man, don't be afraid, man, because that's what you out here for.
That's what it's for. Yeah, don't be afraid. It's all good. Motherfuckers be acting like they definitely allergic. They're like, yo, it's all good to have a genuine connection with people you don't even know. That's how, ain't that how you meet people? Ain't that how you become business partners and going on vacations with each other? Yeah, collabing and all that. How you going to do that if you don't do that and open up to being that?
But, and I, no shot to the no face channels. But when you don't have a face and you're not putting yourself out there, I get it. You don't want to be famous.
Yep. Yeah. You just want to be, get the story out. Nobody know who you are if you out in the streets. Yep.
Yeah. But nah, man, it's about sometimes you got to open up. If you're not that no face person, open up, man.
Yep.
Like if you want to put yourself out there, put yourself out there. Stop being a coward.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Don't make a bunch of enemies if you're going to be trying to do this. Don't make enemies.
Star said that too. I listened to him. He's been in the game for 25 years. He said that, man. Don't come on here and make a bunch of enemies. Yep. He said that.
So, you know, you ain't got to kiss everybody's ass because the thing is, Like, you just want to, what you want to be is genuine to yourself. If you don't rock with a person, just, you know, just don't rock with them.
Just don't rock with them.
But, you know, to the no face channels, man, you only going to be as big as your voice.
Yep, that's the reason why Pink is big. Pink don't never got to show herself, and she's big because her voice is, it got a face to it. So if you like that, I guess. But yeah, Pink, and I want her to show her face. I want to see who Pink is because she's so popping. It'd be irking me sometimes, like, damn, man, I like your channel so much. Your content's so dope. But damn, man, we don't know who the fuck you are. Like, damn.
Yep, and then all the while it'd be some snaggletooth.
Yeah, you won't believe it. Like, with the
or she, like, could be fine. I don't know.
Yeah, she might be real talk. Pink Book Lessons. I'm like, man, I want to see her. Like, you should be fire. You be all non-stop dropping shit. You should be coming with the little catchphrases and the little, you know what I'm saying?
But you know, it just is what, that's why, you know, that's why we linked up, man, just to be. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Be solid, man. I plan on linking with all y'all. You know what I'm saying?
Me too. That's why I keep grinding, you know? Man. Get this money up so I can start to move around this, you know, a couple more states comfortable. Yep, real time.
Yeah, because it ain't nothing, man. Just like, you know, I'm regular just like y'all. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, me too.
You know, we just going to keep turning up, though. You know what I'm saying? That's just what it is. And I hope, like, imagine. I know I'm an inspiration to y'all, but shoot, man, y'all doing the same thing. Like, you've done it before. You've done this.
Yeah.
What I just did, you know what I'm saying? It's just like, shit, man, I ain't going to stop grinding. I ain't going to stop.
Yeah, real talk. That's why, and that's crazy that you said that. That's why when I seen you hit that, I said, man, hold up, man. Let me, you know what I mean? Yeah, let me open up a little bit more, like, bro, you know what I mean? Because I'm like, yeah, man, forget that. So that inspired me in a whole different way. So, you know what I'm saying? I say, yeah, man, you know what? Even if this video get 19 views, still cut it. Don't care about views, man. Care about the story. You liked it. And once you put it out, it's the internet's here. If they going to either like it, it's going to be seen. And who knows? That shit can hit a billion. Fuck it. So I just rap with it, man. I don't even be caring no more.
Yeah, I be, man, I be on there looking for good stuff. I'm always try to find that next high.
Yeah, that's the game. Hell yeah, you got to.
But I ain't gonna stop myself. I'm like, nah, that ain't gonna get it. Nah, I'm gonna just put it out there.
Yep, because you don't. That's how I got my million view video. It was just one that I didn't even, you know what I mean? I ain't had no holds barred. I happened to not cuss crazy and talk my usual, you know what I mean, catchphrases. And man, every day I woke up, it ain't do quick like yours. But every day I woke up, that motherfucker was at 300. The next week, 400 or 500. A month and a half later, 700,000. And then that motherfucker ended up going, now it's at 1.6. And boom, you know what I mean? My channel over there, 22, I had left that channel and stopped. But now I'm back over there dropping videos. All my shit's back in the green. I'm like, wow, if you just continue to start posting back to your channels, they'll start fucking with you again.
Yeah, real shit. When I did that Shannon Sharp video, nigga, I made a plan. I was like, nigga, I'm finna go in here and talk about how much money this nigga made. I did this while I was at work, nigga. I was telling my partner, I said, nigga, this is what I'm finna do. And I did that shit at night when I got off work.
Yeah.
I did that video. And then, shit, I dropped it in the morning. That motherfucker took off. I was
sure
like,
did. I said, damn. I had to re-look. I'm like, no, that don't say. I'm like, oh, that shit say 3 digits with a K on it. Oh, yeah. This nigga shit went up.
Like, so, but that Gail Lewis shit, I was just like,
that Gail Lewis shit was the, oh my God, bro. That's one of the ones crazy. Where it's just like, yo, that shit had legs and just caught it. That motherfucker got legs.
But I was just doing shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
That's what I'm saying. Like, just people be like, oh, I'm trying to make it, nigga. I don't know. You know what I mean?
Yep.
But then once I did it, shit, I just kept going. I just kept it going. I milked that bitch.
Short, real talk. I was about to say, people will talk against themselves. Like, nah, man, maybe I should. Nah, fuck all that. man, keep going. There's going to be some people that's like, dag, this all you going to talk about? Look, man, look, you do know this video is on the internet. You don't got to come watch it from me. You can go watch the whole video. There won't be no pausing. You don't got to hear my annoying voice. You can watch the whole thing for 10 years staring at the fucking TV if you want. Y'all kill me with that. But you know you're over here because I'm doing it, because he's doing it. Just be real with yourself. Damn, you like a motherfucker.
Yeah. Oh, God. They're like, why is the guy just standing over there watching on the side? Motherfucker, I'm observing just like you.
I'm observing just like you, motherfucker. Damn. Oh, he's talking too much. Well, motherfucker, don't watch it where there's no talking. The video's on the internet, goofies.
It's a reaction channel, you big dummy. Yeah.
They just be always got to say some shit. Like, man, ain't nobody tweaking on y'all motherfuckers, man.
But hey, man, hey, love them and hate them at the same time. Man.
Love them and hate them, true, and definitely glad they come every fucking time because it wouldn't be the same without them.
But shout out to all the Charlene supporters in the chat, man. Y'all, motherfuckers.
I said, damn, it's about 700. Because we only got about 200 motherfuckers that support us, so it's about 700 Charlene supporters in this bitch.
Them motherfuckers in here strong. We want to hear the tea. Get y'all goof asses out of here.
Hair care journey. Real shit.
These motherfuckers ain't, they don't never come around. And then you don't talk about them. They don't say nothing. But you say one thing.
Right? They never come around. Yo, they talk the most shit. Got the most fucking tea. Everything's this. But they never pop the fuck up. They never come around. They're trolling sometimes in their comments. A little bald head. Do y'all think that's a diss? Say some real shit. Like, y'all goofy. I see why y'all advocate is goofy, just like y'all. All y'all in this goofy land. Nothing's real to y'all.
Man, hey, it's crazy because these motherfuckers, they talk so much shit, right? They talk more shit on us than they speak positive on their person.
Yep.
And when they speak positive on their person, it's bullshit.
It's bullshit.
It's like, why do you even support them? Because,
like, why? Yeah, like, that's crazy. That's why I'll never get over the Rico situation. He got caught again, and y'all have nothing to say about it. He's just exemplary to be around a woman, her kids, just nothing, huh, y'all? Nothing.
No.
If CJ would have got caught with weed in a legal state, they'll be killing him right now. Like,
no, bro. Hey, they in my comments. They in my comments saying they don't care about Rico.
For real?
Because I made a post on my community page. It's still up there, talking about how I don't see how y'all could support a person that said that they whack for making her the main character and stuff. And new people to my channel was like, who they talk about? Who they talking about? I'm just like, man, Charlene Young. They still don't know. But so this person was like, oh shit, let me see if I can find that motherfucker. But the fact of the matter is they don't hear defending Rico.
Right?
All right, her name is Tonisha Mitchell. She said they weren't talking about Rico. And they asked, do they care about Rico? And she said, let me see. Damn, she said it in one of these comments.
Yeah.
That they don't care about Rico.
They don't care about Rico. Like, what?
And I'm like, so y'all don't care about Rico?
Yeah, so y'all don't care about Rico?
Like, so obviously backdooring the Charlene Nation.
Yeah, right.
They don't care about Rico, in real life. They know that, but they won't tell her that.
Yep, but they won't tell her that. That's crazy to me that they won't tell her that. Like, Charlene, yeah, man, Rico ain't it. They won't just have a fighting up to combat other people. They'll always stand on that and won't tell her that, girl, this dude's not good for you. Yep, that's sad. And even her mom, though, too. That's what's said. She's liking the music and everything. So that's even said that Tanya won't even. But she had no guidance herself, so. Hey,
Tanya's a yes man too. That's crazy.
Yep, Tanya's a yes man too. Yep, that's sad.
Yeah, man, that's crazy. Yeah, I ain't messing with it. That's why I be saying, like, nobody really cares. You know what I'm saying? When it comes down to it, they watch her, but they don't really care.
You're right, because all of her drama videos is popping, but all the videos where she's, like I said, her content with the Leo and the stalker, man, they don't care about that. They tried to hype her up. Oh, good job. It looks good. Y'all know it don't. Y'all not going to even be real with her.
How long did that last?
Yep. And then left for a month. And then look at this last one. I said, Charlene, won't you start doing some of them taste thingies, like where it's ketchup, orange juice, mustard, and everything's bland. She done it, but it was so fucking ghetto and low budget. That, oh my God, girl, you came from the upper echelon of YouTube. How the fuck do your shit look like you startup YouTube? This is crazy.
Yeah. Shit, man. She didn't even put no effort into it.
Yep. She just wore the outfits, and every time he brought the outfit, she wanted to pose in front of cars. She put effort in that. Like, oh, I'm an upstage Nike. Yeah, I got your baby dad. That's where all the effort went. Yep. Because, bitch, your baby dad got me a bust down. Yep. So that's
she should have been a model then.
Yep.
She could have been a model.
Yep. That's why she got her knees done, lipoed, her waist. She got teeth, Leonidas abs.
She got her knees done?
Oh, yeah. Look, I put out that video like last month where somebody sent me her little invoice for what she got. She got 360 lipo, but okay, so that's all around your 360. And then she got her thighs, and then also some of the fat. And once they go to your thighs, they said the knees, her thighs, 360 lipo. Oh man, I gotta try to find it. Yeah, it's a little invoice somebody sent me.
And bro, she is tall as hell.
Invoice. Yep, abs, Leonidas abs done, teeth, butt, titties, 360 lipo. And it's some. I'm gonna try to find it real quick on my page. This shit was incredible. I'm saying, yo, she really got all this shit. Yep, CJ paid for all that shit. And this is how you treat a nigga. He corrected your whole shape. And this is how you treat niggas. Unreal.
What's up, Tiffany? Tiffany keeping it lit. We got Tish in the building. Haircut Journey been keeping it lit. T6 been keeping it lit.
I'm gonna just scroll a couple thingies. I'm gonna just scroll a couple fucking videos.
Let me see. Keeping it lit.
Damn, I wish I gotta find this shit. Yeah, man. Let me see. I gotta find that shit.
AC or Ace? I think I remember her in the video, but
yeah, I know. Yeah. I got that thumbnail. I didn't probably with that on the thumbnail, so I'm gonna just look.
Got her knees. She got a BBL on her knees.
Yeah, yep. She got a BBL on her knees. Oh, I gotta find this. Hold up. Here it goes. I found it. So look, she got a bridge. This is what she got. She got a Brazilian butt augmentation, tummy tuck, liposuction, knees, thighs, waist, hips. Oh my! Now I'm gonna go into it. That's just the thumbnail. Now I'm going to go into it and show y'all the video. This is all what she got. Unreal, bro. She got the whole thingy. She's a real live Mrs. Potato Head. She got her whole everything done.
Hey, man, Jay Wolf, I sent somebody some money so we can have a fight over the internet about sending the cash out. I did it specifically so we could start an online fight and we could break up.
Yeah.
And then we could come back together, act like we really support each other. Like
hell yeah. Because you can play. Yeah, real shit. Because Charleston taught a nigga how to play on this internet, boy. I play on y'all. Hell yeah.
Man, these motherfuckers. Hey, man. So here's the thing. You know what? You know what's crazy?
I'm putting it on the big TV, but go ahead. Okay. Yeah.
What's crazy is, it's crazy that they went to war over $500, because I remember Jason got a $500 deal. I didn't think nothing of it. Like, what am I going to get mad at this motherfucker for getting some money for?
He gave me two of them. Real talk. I was like, wow. I wasn't expecting that. Like, damn.
Yeah.
Fab, and then another day, not even long from that, hit me with another fab.
Like, that's a blessing, bro. That's a, like, why would you be mad at somebody doing that? Like,
yeah.
Especially, like it's crazy, man. I don't know, man. I'm just not a hater like that, though.
Me neither. I'll say it over and over again. When I seen that your shit hit crazy like that, I blinked and said, oh, this nigga done it. He said it like, nigga, 2024, man, forget that rug dumpster. And the nigga jumped over. I said, the nigga done it. I said, oh, okay, he was right. All right, so I'm going to still fuck with her, but I ain't nobody focused on her. I said, all right, man, open back up, bro. You got other pages. You know how to do this shit. Yeah, man, yeah. Open up. And you helped open the nigga back up. That's why I'm not no hater, man. What the fuck, bro?
Yeah, I'm telling you, man, you can't be a hater. You got to be a worker in this, yep, bitch. Like, it ain't even about, like, any day could be your day if you work hard enough.
That's what I keep telling everybody. I said, yo, any day could be your day. DDG said, look, man, if you throw 10 videos up on the wall, just, look, one of them's going to, like, yo, three of them might not do nothing. Even seven. One of them out of 10 is going to do something. Yeah, just start throwing groups of shit against the wall. Shit going stick.
My nigga, I used to drop 5 videos just to get 100 views a day.
Yep. Hey, the Poor Man Podcast said that too, because he was in the, he was like a professional league or sports, and he hurt his back, so he had to become a YouTuber. He said, or just not had to. He started doing it. He said his first videos would get 19 views. Now this nigga got hundreds of thousands of subscribers. Your boy, the Poor Man Podcast, he's popping. He said he would look at his video with not, and that was me too. I started in 2021. I would get 19 views and be like, man, I don't give a fuck. Stand up to 6 in the morning like, oh, well, let me just go ahead and find shit. Do it. It's all good. I'm doing it. I don't even care. Getting less than 100 views and shit on 70 videos before it start, you know, taking off a little bit. Like, okay, that one got 1,000. That one got 600. And then I said, oh, okay, it's real. Now I'm just start working it a little bit more and boom.
Yeah.
So look, this is what she got. This is crazy, bro. This is crazy. Resilient. I like my beard right there. I gotta grow it back like that.
I'll show y'all, like, oh, you can't see. I say, damn. Oh, I can't see it.
Oh, yep, because it's white. Yep. Oh, I see a graph. Yep.
95,000.
Oh, man, that's crazy.
48 hours, nigga, like, we're not playing around here.
Yeah, 48 hours, nigga, 100,000. Nigga, that's what my shit pulled this month, 126. His shit did that in 2 days. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. We're not playing. We're grinding over here, man. Stop playing, nigga, like, shit, man. I've been on the grind, man. Nigga, I ain't never been so happy in my life, bro.
Real shit. Damn, so, a 95 piece overnight, motherfucker, 48.
Nigga, but no, yesterday it was at 123.
Shit, so it's real, just, boy. Yeah. Hell yeah.
Man, shit, y'all better stop playing, man. I've been on the grind. I don't get the one day numbers. I get it. Like, you want to see your video do numbers today.
Today. Yeah,
everybody want that, man. But, man.
Yep. Everybody, it's okay, man. Sometimes I like getting put back into perspective, like, oh, all right, get the video that didn't really do nothing. Yeah, it's cool.
Yeah, you want them shits that people gonna keep watching over, yep, and over and over.
Yeah, they call that green content. They call that, yeah, green or something. No, evergreen. Yeah,
evergreen content.
Yep, mm-hmm. I've been learning. I've been going to the analytics over there in the school, and I'm like, man, let me learn some of this shit. Not just the video. I'm always, come on. Let me learn over there. Yep, evergreen shit that they'll watch from 5 years from now. The motherfucker will click on that shit. Yep.
Yeah. So, you know, this is just free game for everybody who want to be a content, yep, creator. Like,
look, y'all, she got her knees and everything done. I hope y'all can hear that computer, bitch. She got abdominoplasty. and she got the platinum recovery kit.
So, a little birdie flew past.
Yeah, look, she got that. Like, she got a tummy tuck mini. It's called a tummy tuck mini. She got a tummy tuck mini, liposuction two areas, inner thighs and knees. So she got liposuction on her inner thighs and knees. She got a Brazilian butt augmentation with 360 lipo, full abdomen, waist, and lower back. And then she got a tummy tuck mini. Man, this girl got her whole but Leonidas abs. I call them the Cardi B. You know what I mean? The Cardi B's look like a washboard and shit. Like you've been doing sit-ups for a whole 10 months. Them motherfuckers just like sculpt your shit like clay. Like you ain't worked for them. That's abdominoplasty. Or whatever. And then the mini tummy tuck. Man, this girl OCJ her life. And then got her teeth fixed.
Man, I need that. I need that Leonidas thing. Let me get that. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Get that.
Leonidas, she got jealous, right? She got the Leonidas kit.
That's I got a six pack under there.
Leonidas. She got this Leonidas kit.
Yeah, I got a six pack under there. You know what I'm saying? You just got
it. Yeah. Damn, she got, yeah, right, her knees, her knee, that's crazy. So Charlene's whole body is easy bake oven.
Yeah, shoulders, knees, and toes, knees, and toes.
Hell yeah. Easy bake oven.
That's crazy.
That's sad.
Yeah, I mean, she could have just worked out for it, but I mean, yeah. Who am I to judge? I ain't going to judge nobody for whatever.
Me neither. That's why I was like, it is what it is. Hey, yeah, right? Yeah, Coach Tish. Campbell got the same surgery. Yep, we done souffled him. The male BBL, hell yeah. He got the whole surgery.
Hey, The Rock did it too, but The Rock was actually, you know what I'm saying, cut up, but he just, yep. He wanted to look good for his movie roles and all that.
Yep, so The Rock had a little more excuse because we see he played football. He wasn't just this lazy man, so.
Oh, my boy. Well, we have turned this into the PJ show. I think, I don't know. My boy's phone just went dead. But, yeah. So, check this out, man. Let's get into this. Who is this? Trust? No. Trust not. What are you talking about? Get me out of here. I'm about to be lit. I'm about to be lit. Okay. Until Jason get over here, we're going to be lit. Okay, let's keep it lit, big dog. Okay, let's talk about Charlene. Okay, let's talk about her teeth. First of all, they separating like they separate like blacks and whites in the 60s, okay? bitch teeth say next to 1 mile looking ass. Okay. I'm going to tell you what. Charlene's teeth look like, you know when the penguin bit into that fish, that's what her teeth look like. Just got blue blood all on them. Just terrible. Okay. Just terrible. Okay. She could have not went and got a BBL. I don't even think she went and got a BBL. I think I could be lying, but I could be right about what she really got. But she didn't go get a BBL because you actually have to transfer fat, okay? If you transfer fat to any of the areas that she was looking to have fat transferred from, She had a small pooch in the front, right? So that's about 1 ounce of fat. Oh, yeah. She'll take that 1 ounce of fat from this. Remember, she didn't have no breasts. Like if you look at her breasts now, they look like two water balloons. Like if you take a water balloon and you fill it up and you know you stretch it like that And you know how that all the water like stretched down? That's what her breasts look like. Okay. They don't look fun. Everybody call them fun bags, but they don't look fun. They look, they were deflated and now they inflated and now they shrunk down because she lost weight. And so like the skin behind the breast, behind the implant is starting to touch. Cause when it started to heal, it healed together. So now it's healed like, and so you got the breast out here and it looked like a pacifier nipple, but just bigger. It looked like a big pacifier nipple. So she got two pacifier nipples on the front of her chest. Okay. Y'all know, yes, thank you, Dr. PJ. Two pacifier nipples. See, that's what we call them, the pacifier nipples, okay? And so with her, it also tends to loosen up the skin because of her skin. She has a skin disorder, okay? Her skin disorder, it makes her skin extra stretchy. So now she got these two pacifier nipples. So now that she's getting older, they starting to sag. And so when she moved, now they move like they real, but it looked like two pacifier nipples that could just move on the wind. Like, I'm just saying. If y'all, I'm just saying, okay. That's why the kids couldn't be breastfed, because her actual nipple, so you're supposed to have a nipple, like you're supposed to have a nipple that, like you have a teat and you have a nipple. So you're supposed to have that. But what happened is it stretched the skin out so much, the nipple flattened. So she has flattened nipples on top of the saggy titties. So she don't really have a hard nipple. So her nipple can't actually, when it gets hard, it's just the center part. It don't really like stick out. Like most women with voluptuous breasts, when they nipple get hard, they stick out. Well, hers, just like the center part gets hard, just like it don't really do that. Looks weird, to be honest. Looks weird. But don't take my word for it. Everything flat, back flat. I just posted a video. I posted a picture of Charlene on my Instagram. So if you follow me on Instagram, let me show y'all this picture of Charlene. Y'all probably won't be able to see it because my phone be doing some bullshit when I be on Instagram. But, did somebody send? Ooh, no, she didn't. This must be a scammer. Okay, this person's a scammer. Ain't nobody sending you no goddamn money. I wonder if somebody asking for Cash App money on Instagram is an instant red flag. Okay? Instant red flag. And what was I about to show y'all? Oh, yeah. I was about to show y'all a picture of Charlene. This is Charlene. Okay, CJ sent me this picture of Charlene of her butt before her BBL. Y'all don't laugh. Do not laugh, okay? This is Charlene's butt before the BBL, okay? Charlene's butt before the BBL. Okay. It was terrible. Okay. It went straight up her back. Okay. And I didn't want to expose that. Y'all told me that. I said I didn't want to expose all of Charlene. Like I said, I didn't want to expose it, but here it is. Y'all got it. Okay. Now, I know y'all been waiting. I don't know. Y'all gotta come to Desk Chat tomorrow. Go to Desk Live tomorrow to see the actual receipts of the begging, okay? It's gonna be there. But anyway, yeah. I found another picture of Charlene online. I found another picture of Charlene online, and I wanted to share it with y'all. This is a sexy picture of Charlene that none of y'all ever seen. I promise y'all, if y'all ever seen this photo, like, I'm finna expose it. Like, I wasn't supposed to do this, but I'm gonna do this because we lit up in here tonight. This is where Charlene sent this photo. This is a photo she sent to CJ a long time ago. All right.